So Danish fans absolutely delighted with both of the men's singles semi-finals, because two Danes through to contest tomorrow's final. First time that that's happened in 12 years, since 2008, when Peter GER beat Jochen Pearson in the final. Well, one more semi-final to come, and it's mixed doubles, and it's Lamsfuss and Herttrich up against Ellis and Smith. And when we look at the draw, we can see that in the first of the mixed semi-finals, it was Chris and Gabby Adcock that got through. So it's a possibility that it could be an all-English mixed doubles final. Now, that has never happened since the inception of the Super Series, and now HSBC BWF World Tour, in any Super Series or World Tour event of level 4 and above. So the equivalent of a Super Series. Never have we had two English pairs in the final. But prior to the inception of the Super Series, we did have two English pairs in the final of the Denmark Open, going back 14 years, 2006, the year before the inception of the Super Series. And Anthony Clark and Donald Kellogg beat Nathan Robertson and Gail Emms. Now, I've got that all wrong, because there was two semi-finalists that year in 2006. Not two finalists, I do apologise. Getting all excited by the fact that an English pair and something that has never happened before could possibly happen for the first time ever.
At the European Championship, they are from Germany. Mark Lamsfuss, Isabel Herttrich.
So the number four seeds from years of age from Germany, then Juul and van der Aar from the Netherlands, and then in the quarterfinal beat Bay and Lungor. Close opening game in their quarterfinal, 23-21 and 21-12 in the second for the English pair. Well, as far as I can research, because not all Denmark Opens results go back to the first ever in 1935. As far as I can make out, I think the German pair could become the first German mixed doubles pair to contest the final at the Denmark Open. Certainly in the Open era, no German pair. And the Open era in badminton goes back to the early 1980s. Our court officials from Denmark and Finland.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Isabel Herttrich, Mark Lamsfuss, Germany. And on my left, Lorne Smith, Marcus Ellis, England. Isabel Herttrich to serve to Marcus Ellis. Level. Play.
So will it be an all-English mixed doubles final here at the Denmark Open, or will the first German pair get through to the final in the Open era? Smash from Mark Lamsfuss across the body of Lauren Smith. And of course, Marcus Ellis is already in a final tomorrow. The men's doubles with Chris Langridge. And the last male player to reach two finals here at the Denmark Open in the same year. You have to go back 15 years to Lars Porsker, who lost both finals that he contested. Men's doubles with Jonas Rasmussen and mixed doubles with Helle Nilsson. As I was telling you earlier, this is the seventh meeting between these two pairs. The advantage held with the English combination won four of the previous six. But the interesting thing is, all six previous matches have been won and lost in two straight games. If it was to follow the same pattern, this opening game is obviously vital. Oh, that's well taken from Lauren Smith.
Service over.
3-5. Oh, that was mighty close.
5-0.
Well, Herttrich was thinking about... Ooh, I think that was in. She was thinking about challenging. I think she probably should have challenged. Yeah, it was clearly in. Oh, that's a terrific shot from Herttrich.
7-5.
Look at that angle. I don't know whether Ellis actually saw that Lamsfuss was stepping forward to receive the defensive shots. Look at him. But Ellis very cleverly focusing on the steepness of shot rather than the power of the shot.
Seven all. Lauren to receive. Yeah. Oh. Service over.
That's a good interception.
8-0. Service over. 9-8.
Unlucky for Herttrich. Oh, my goodness, she was quick onto that. Brilliant again.
Service over.
He's a tall man. He's Mark Lamsfuss.
10-0.
Just over 6 foot one. 186. It's more than just the power. It was the placement too, across the body of Lauren Smith. Utterly brilliant.
11-10, interval.
Isabel Herttrich really hunting the shuttle at the net. Look at that lovely block, first of all. Well, immediately moves forward.
She feeds off the
the German combination. We have the advantage, albeit just 1 point advantage at the mid-game interval.
That was a full-out one, I thought.
But I can take more pace with it.
Just keep it varied, that's all I'm thinking. She gets latching onto heart power. Right, when we're lifting him, face him.
Yeah,
he's trying to get across here on you. Yeah, so be ready for that. Yeah, exactly. And just what we're doing is good. Just got to try and find her more.
20 seconds.
No. Constantly, come on. Good pace, everything. Come on, thank you.
Wenn er so langsam zum Netz spielt, die schickt, sie rennt da auch voll lang dann rauf. Spielt ein bisschen hinter sie oder sind wir bei Pedersen so auf die Schulter, so ein bisschen weiter rein. Ja? Du hattest am Anfang des Satzes ein paar Treffer hier im Midcourt halt, den kannst du auch einfach so aufs Tee runterlegen, dann schiebt sich danach wieder.
11,
hinter
Bell. Ich habe das Gefühl, dass irgendwie gerade außen Platz ist.
Play!
Ja, aber entweder, wenn sie das ist, kannst du mal so ein bisschen gewischt spielen.
Well, the English coach, Anthony Clark, half of the last English partnership to win the title here at the Denmark Open. That was 14 years ago, 2006, with Donna Kellogg, the Leybourne and Yule in the final. There he is. Oh, that's a bum on the line. Interesting that Anthony Clark had noticed what I had noticed, that Lamsfuss was catching Lauren Smith with the smash across the body. Oh, that's fast play from Marcus Ellis.
12-11.
From her perspective,
11.
Set herself up. There's the attempted smash across the body again. It's all 3 points since the mid-game interval going to the English pair.
Oh,
that comes to an end.
12. 13.
Great return of serve.
14-12.
What was he expecting serving out wide? Surely he was expecting a push straight down the line. Why wasn't he covering it, Mark Lamsfuss? That's good work from the tall German. Well, called a fault for hitting the net. Well, something hit the net. Either it was a shuttle or a racket, but unfortunately, I don't think we're going to see from the net camera. Oh, yes, that's perfect. Lovely 16, push
14.
Deep into the backhand corner of Marcus Ellis. First one to the half-court area, and then one really deep. That was super play. This is a good little run by Lamsfuss and Herttrich. Five straight points. Just don't understand 17. It. I mean, we often see players, they appear to be ready, then they just let the shuttle drop and say, I wasn't ready. Students stop. That's a great return of a flick serve. Well done, Herttrich. But all this not ready would soon stop if umpires started to call the point and said, in that instance, have said, well, point to Smith, because you were ready.
Over. 16-18.
Come on.
Service over. 19-16.
A bit dispirited at the moment, Ellis. Oscar clear from Herttrich, perhaps. Not the right choice of shot.
Oh. Oh. Service over. 20 game points.
So game point 17. Opportunities. Three of them for Lamsfuss and Herttrich. Lucky to get away with that. Real hesitation, 18, confusion initially. 20. Who was going to go for that? Smith called to her partner. You go. So one game point has come and gone. But the second one is converted by the number four seeds, Mark Lamsfuss and Isabel Herttrich.
21-18.
21-18 confirms umpire Larsen of Denmark.
Are we okay?
21-18.
Too many errors, that's all.
Okay. In 20
so
minutes.
So let's go again. Okay, tactically you're doing okay. You know, could we play her more? Yeah, a little bit. Okay, so when we do flick her, get a good bit of height on it, since you can't get the quick shot in. Yeah?
Think we need to do some long and
yeah, mix some, it up.
Yeah. But vary it still. But she naturally wants to do things like when he's smashing, she completely comes off around the head. So can we get the odd block in when he does smash at us? I'm not saying it's easy, but just things to try.
For example, from the fall out, switching right across. She's just looking off.
Yeah. So can we put it back that side?
Well.
Or middle even. Yeah, a natural way is just to follow the line of where we smashed. Okay. See if we can, when we play down the sides, so when we've played that nice block down to her forehand side and he pushes up, he's only ever gone straight so far. So cover that one. So when you turn that one, that first one to that side, he'll push up and play straight back down the line. Whether you go completely over the top over her, or whether you can be earlier and hold him so you can get that layoff in.
So they're not just like pushing back.
Yeah. Well, they're not playing to the net as such, because when you have, you've tried to get on it.
Like winning
the 20 seconds. Well, if you go earlier, you've got to go earlier. Yeah. So we command that, but it does expose you at the back. Okay. So we've both got to do that together if we're doing that.
Very good. Nur beide?
Ja.
Arbeitsbereitschaft. Ne? Diese Punkte, die wir gesagt haben, Arbeitsbereitschaft und Disziplin. Wenn wir ein bisschen spät dran sind, können wir immer wieder helfen. Eure Abwehr ist gut. Wichtig ist, dass sie aktiv ist. Und schaut, dass wenn ihr aus der Abwehr einmal pusht, danach immer klar sein auf dem Block. Ja, da ist es manchmal noch zu reaktiv. Ja? Genau. Geh, genau.
Okay.
Geh rauf auf den Ball, aktiv.
Yeah, well, the umpire's just waiting for the music to be switched off in the arena here. There we go. Oh, that's nice.
One love.
Good interception from Marcus Ellis.
Unsighted.
Well, the umpire is asking for Hawkeye to adjudicate on this. Great serve.
Yes. To love. Serve is over. One chance?
Yeah.
Lamsfuss challenges called out.
Oh, it's awfully early in a game to be challenging. With only two challenges per game. Not sure that I would have chanced a challenge at this stage, especially as it's now wasted.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. One, two. Play.
Over. 3-1. That's a service good return over. From Lamsfuss.
2-3.
Apologises for getting the neck cord. But he earned his own luck there. Serve, but you've got to make your opponents play. Errors on the return are just gifts for your opponent. So it was a little bit loose.
4-5.
Got what it deserved, in all honesty. Yeah, you can see from that it was too high over the net.
Hey,
Ellis. What a smash from Marcus Ellis.
Six.
Power and angle. Just wide, but great persistent attack from the English pair. Far more aggressive now in the second game than they were in the first.
Play.
Keep the rally going that long, Ellis.
Seven. Oh.
She's hunting the shuttle more now, Lauren Smith. Oh. Yeah, has proved again in that rally.
10-7.
I think it comes off the frame of Lauren's racket here. That one, yeah, it did. Oh, my word, that's good.
9-10.
This is good comeback.
Ten all.
So as with the first game, there'll only be one point in it at the mid-game interval. Every game it was the Germans who had the slight advantage.
Oh.
This time it's the English pair. 11-10 in favour of the number two seeds.
Genau. Genau richtig. Wenn wir rausliften, schauen, dass wir da, wenn wir zurückpushen, den nächsten auf jeden Fall dann wieder Fallen spielen halt. Ja. Ja? Und genauso Bell in dem 50-50 auch versucht den Fallen und versucht dann auch die, auf die Rückhandseite zu spielen, dass ihr nicht nur Tempowechsel so macht, sondern auch eine kleine Drehung halt macht. Ja? Dass die was machen, sondern die gehen die einfach stumpf immer gerade rauf, dass wir die links-rechts dann bewegen. Ja? Wenn wir 60-40 Treffer haben, gib ruhig Gas dann halt so. Ja, und wenn die viel zurückbekommen, dann sind, gerade wenn du reinkommst, mach einmal Gas und dann wieder runter aus 40.
Being fast, being early, doing what we can, no matter what happens, they will give us ends. They're that kind of pair. They can blow it. Yeah, so stick in there, be strong all the time. If we play great badminton, 11, bonus. 10. Yeah? Like I said, play. Let him take that mid.
Yeah,
can push up a little bit. I'm not going to lift you much.
No.
20 seconds. Oh!
Oh, it's a good return of serve.
Serve is over.
Imparted a little bit of topspin in that, but trick. Like a mentally tired shot, not necessarily physically tired. Oh, nicely played. Both the English players backing off the
13-11.
Net. Yeah, well, Marcus Ellis had blocked to the net, so usually he would follow forward. Lift there from Marcus Ellis simply wasn't good enough. Needed more pace on it. That's well worked.
Service over. 13-14. Is that okay? Yeah. Yeah, change.
Done well. Back level. Nicely played.
Service over.
She's always looking 14. To block or drive off her defence, Herttrich, and then immediately move forward. She doesn't just defend and stand where she is, always after that defensive shot. As long as it's a driver or block, she looks to go forward to the net. Just missed time to jump. Is she all right?
16-14.
No, she's hurt herself.
Yeah, need a doctor. Oh. The doctor needs to come on. Okay, can you just walk on in and that's okay?
Oh, yes. That, okay. Was that just jarring an ankle or something? Yeah, just hopped after that awkward movement.
Okay, Lauren? Yeah, fine.
Yeah, she said to the umpire, I just need a moment. Yeah, you can sometimes, if you step on it quite heavily on an ankle with awkward movement, yeah, it can be a little painful momentarily.
Marcus, yeah. 16-14.
Punch clear.
Service over. 15-16.
Well, this is far from over yet, you know. There was hesitation. He was watching the shuttle. He looked down at the back line, decided he needed to play it. There he has a look. And by the time he's got his bearings again, he'd let the shuttle drop too low.
Play.
Oh, that's brilliant. Well taken by Lauren Smith. But the block
16,
from Herttrich, this one, that was magnificent. And an even better kill from the net from Lauren Smith. Between the legs. Oh, that's amazing from Mark Lamsfuss. A little bit of trickery in the middle of that. Look at that.
16.
And played the perfect shot. Got the nerve.
Mark, play.
Yeah. the flick serve. Oh, that's brilliant. What a good defensive shot, driving it to the mid-court area across court.
19,
stepped into it.
17.
Lovely play from Lamsfuss. So a two-point advantage and 2 points away from making history. Becoming the first German mixed doubles pair in the final of the Denmark Open in the Open era.
Service over. 18-19. Play. Marcus is ready. Play.
So 18-19. Yeah, he's done that so often in this match, Mark Lamsfuss. The smash across the body of Lauren Smith.
20 match points.
Forcing 18. The error. Terrific placement. Match point opportunities for Lamsfuss and Herttrich. Lamsfuss and Isabel Herttrich. First German pair to get through to the final of the mixed doubles here at the Denmark Open in the Open era. 21-18, 21-18, symmetry in the scoreline.
21-18.
46 minutes for that victory. And the number four seeds from Germany beat the number two seeds from England. So it won't be two finals tomorrow for Marcus Ellis. But he will be playing in the men's doubles final. But their confirmation, 21-18, 21-18 for Lamsfuss and Herttrich. So as they take leave of centre stage, it means that semi-final action is over for today, but we can reflect on what's happened on semi-finals day, which all started with women's doubles and the winners of this tournament 2 years ago in the three-time World Championship silver medalists Fukushima and Hirota had to come from 7-15 down in the opening game, but from that point they only lost another 9 points in closing out the match against Busch and Schultz. Then it was women's singles and the Olympic champion Carolina Marin through to her first ever Denmark Open final by beating Yvonne Lee from Germany in two straight games. Marcus Ellis and Chris Langridge, the Olympic bronze medalists, overcame the young dames Ipe and Kier. And then in the women's doubles, the two-time reigning world champions Matsumoto and Nagahara beating the European champions to set up an all-Japanese women's doubles final tomorrow. Then it was the first of the men's singles semi-finals and Rasmus Gimke of Denmark beating Kenta Nishimoto, the Asian Games bronze medalist, in two straight games. Nozomi Okuhara was outstanding today against Michelle Lee, only dropped 17 points in total. So the beaten finalist from last year trying to go one better tomorrow, Okuhara that is. Then it was the second of the men's singles and Anders Antonsen, the World Championship silver medalist. He has made it through by beating the world number two, Cho Tien Chen, in two straight games, setting up an all-Danish men's singles final. First time that's happened here in 12 years. And as we've just seen in the mixed doubles, Lamsfuss and Herttrich, the number four seeds, beating the number two seeds, the European Games gold medalists, in two straight games. 21-18, 21-18. So finals tomorrow, a little later than the semi-finals today. It's 12 noon local time.